Peter Kalumu, Member of Parliament for Homa Bay Town Constituency, has written a letter to the Cabinet Secretary for Education, Ambassador Amina Mohammed, indicating that he is dissatisfied with the manner in which the government is managing the examination. Once again, I almost said election. He feels that this is militarization, just like the story by Wangira indicated there. And he feels that while every effort meant to secure the integrity of national examinations must be encouraged, excessive hype, militarization, and broadcast of measures instituted against exam leakage have the converse negative impact of inviting undeserved suspicion around the examination and diminishing the status of the national education certificates, while also creating a tense examination season and intimidating examination environment for candidates. The foreigners visiting Kenya during national examination season would be forgiven to believe the country has entrenched such a high level of dishonesty in exams that everything comes aground during examinations, even as no effort is spared to stop candidates from cheating. Now, you are protesting what you're calling militarization, but from the onset, the government has appeared to be of the view that it needs to secure this exercise because of the history that we've been through. And specifically, the epitome of that was in 2015, when almost each and every paper was leaked, both at KCPE and KCSE. Don't you think that that background warrants the kind of action we are seeing now?
Sam, let me first wish all the candidates, both for KCPE and KCSE, mm-hmm. In our national exams for this year, you know, success in their endeavors. And I want to wish them good luck. I need to tell you, Sam, that my first child is among the candidates doing, you know, his KCPE. Mm-hmm. Examination management mm-hmm. is a system. You cannot do it as an individual. Mm-hmm. We have laws, we have administrative procedures, mm-hmm. we have institutions we have established mm-hmm. to manage exams. Mm-hmm. And for examination in particular, Sam, we have the Kenya National Examination Council, mm-hmm. which Parliament funds from taxpayers' money, not only to set but also to regulate mm-hmm. and manage the mm-hmm. examination and secure that we have integrity mm-hmm. in our examination, we don't have leakage. Mm-hmm. When you see the whole government running around, including the president, mm-hmm. you know, purporting to be in schools during exams, mm-hmm. one, it is a vote of no confidence in the system we have established to manage exams. They are simply saying that Kenya National Examination Council mm-hmm. cannot do it alone, or if doing it alone cannot do it effectively. Remember, every center where exam is being undertaken under the law and regulation, Sam, mm-hmm. we have what we call an examination center administrator or manager, mm-hmm. and that is the head of that institution, the head teacher or the principal. Mm-hmm. We then have examination supervisors. Mm-hmm. We have then the invigilators, mm-hmm. you know, in respect of each place, not just center, but each stream or classroom mm-hmm. or hall where, you know, candidates or laboratory where candidates are doing exams.
Right.
Now, the question you want to ask is, what are cabinet secretaries doing out there? Mm-hmm. Some go across the entire world. Mm-hmm. If you go to the United Kingdom, for instance, they are doing their exams each day. You will not watch it on BBC. You will not watch a news item that in Sky News or wherever that some exams are being done. We have American system through to Canada and others. Mm-hmm. You will not hear that now, you know, candidates in the United States are doing what particular national exam.
But
why I'm condemning this
right.
is that they may think that being physically present mm-hmm. you know, is adding any value to the supervision process. Mm-hmm. Assume, for instance, Amina went there and found, you know, the possibility of cheating. Mm-hmm. What will she do? Still, it falls upon the invigilator, the supervisor, and the center manager mm-hmm. to report. And by the way, we have put very firm, you know, penal measures mm-hmm. around the people we have put in those, you know, offices to guard our examination process. Why I'm condemning this
right.
is that, remember, a news media like Citizen mm-hmm. is the most popular one we have in the region now, not just nationally. And I can tell you, I'm being watched even in the United States. Mm-hmm. When the whole world is watching and seeing that during exams everything has come to a halt, even the president is in examination centers, and assurances are going out that there will be no cheating, there will be no leakage. Mm-hmm. Essentially, we are confirming to the world that our examination system is too porous
but don't you think the converse argument is true, that you have to do this, or these efforts will move towards ensuring that those people who may want to still penetrate through the system do not have that opportunity? It also gives confidence in the candidates and the nation that this is a pretty secured exercise.
Sam, how does a cabinet minister in a single institution secure integrity of exams? My thinking is this.
No, as a politician, you know the place of symbolism.
I can say, and let me say, Sam, that there is a way in which the president of the country can signify mm-hmm. to candidates nationally mm-hmm. his wish for them, mm-hmm. both in terms of success and integrity of exams. Mm-hmm. In fact, I would have been very happy with the situation where before the exams set up, the president even takes to his usual platform, calls the media, mm-hmm. and says, I'm wishing all young Kenyans approaching their exams, good luck, and I want them to be composed. It is mere graduation. We are going to have 100% transition, as he's doing. mm-hmm. And then he trusts the institutions and the management system we put down there mm-hmm. to do it.
Do you trust the systems yourselves, that the president should actually have confidence in them and let them allow them free hand to execute their mandate?
I'm a believer in institutions. I'm a believer in system, and I'm one person who says if systems are not working, you overhaul them, you firm them up, you make them better. Mm-hmm. What I condemn is the too much noise you make around exams. You're making exams appear to be a matter of life and death. Remember, the only thing we are doing with KCP, for instance, Sam, is to enable us decide which child is going to which school, because we are going to have 100% transition. Mm-hmm. I mean, look at even cartoons in the media. Mm-hmm. The police officers are there mm-hmm. with the guns. The parents are saying, if you don't pass, don't come home. Mm-hmm. The government is saying, we will punish both the candidates and the parents if we do not get good, if there is leakage. If, for instance, Sam, you are saying there is no leakage, why are you bothered about fake papers being done? If you are sure the one you have for the candidates is not leaked,
because it still abuses the integrity of the examination and also puts into the minds of the young Kenyans some expectations that may not be true.
I can tell you, I want you to review the photos you are showing the nation there mm-hmm. very keenly. You may take it for granted when you go like Professor Magoa and say, no candidate has complained that we are our presence is intimidating them. But remember, yes. they will not tell you. Mm-hmm. For a candidate, Sam, you and I did exams. There is a lot going through your heart and mind in the exam room. Mm-hmm. When Amina is passing across there, you may be smiling, she's greeting you. But what thoughts? The CS is distracting you from your thinking. And I've been in Kenya to me long enough to know the things that we do for commotion's sake and the things which can give value. What I'm requesting is that, one, we reduce too much noise around exams. It mm-hmm. portrays us negatively. Mm-hmm. It portrays our exam system and our certificates mm-hmm. as some things lacking integrity. Mm-hmm. When a foreigner comes to Kenya now, they would think mm-hmm. we are such cheats, even from childhood,
right.
that even the president must go securing there. Number two, mm-hmm. let us not appear to militarize mm-hmm. the system. Yesterday, Sam, I decided during the 1 o'clock break before the composition to take to my child lunch. Do you imagine I could not access the school? I mean, what is this thing that people are doing that you cannot just, seek to supervise, ensure that there is no extra or extraneous material is entering the exam room, and then just let, the candidates do their exams in a free atmosphere?
But look at it.
There are areas where we will need security. Mm-hmm. But Sam, what comes to the mind of a child whose parent was arrested by the police the previous day when he's seeing police for the first time in close range within the school there? The police should be there to protect the candidates from external interferences. Not that you have a police officer with guns around, the examination center or even in the examination room, purporting to be supervising exams. What I know as a leader, and this I want to tell Kenyans,
right.
is that I'm not saying this in bad faith. In fact, I've suggested to the minister mm-hmm. that let us review mm-hmm. how we do our things around exams. From the time of Matiang'i, you remember you talked of 2015, there's been a lot of noise mm-hmm. around education. Mm-hmm. We are in a situation where, as a country, Sam, in a critical sector like education, I have a son going to Standard 4, he does not even know the textbooks to buy. And by the way, we praise a lot of commotion instead of asking meaningfully what systems and infrastructure do we put in place to secure that things happen without, you know, too much commotion, too much noise. What I had expected of the minister, and I would suggest this going into the future, is that the monies they are using for choppers now, these are monies which ought to have been added to invigilators down there. And then you mandate the invigilators to ensure secure invigilation. If there isn't sufficient punishment for invigilators who connive in exam cheating, you secure they are there. The minister should be in office somewhere at Jogo Annex B, receiving reports on how exams are going and suggesting both legislative and administrative measures for us as members of parliament to help in firming up. If it is budgetary allocation, that is what we deal with. But I've been in Kenya as a leader long enough to know when you see the government machinery is on the move the way it is, it is not about exams. And I would challenge you, Sam, after this examination is done, go to the budget line for the Ministry of Education and Examination Supervision. Go to the respective ministries and sectors, and you'll see billions and billions of money which never reached the supervisors and invigilators. It has gone somewhere in this purported move. Let us not pretend that a cabinet secretary can invigilate. I mean, in Homa Bay County, where we don't have a cabinet secretary, a PS, or any of these officers you're talking about, who is invigilating then? We must entrust the system we've established, strengthen it, firm it up, and stop idling around pretending we are wishing candidates
you're good actually luck calling it idling around.
It is loitering around.
First of all, the claim that you said about billions of shillings being spent on the execution of this monitoring, that is just a claim, according to Peter Kaluma, so we cannot
verify
it.
It's a claim I've told you but to watch after.
Okay, I want to refer you to one of the points that you have raised in your letter to CS Amina. You're saying that police officers deployed to secure exams should never be in uniform, especially within and around examination centers. The presence of the officers within the institutions or around the examination centers should be inconspicuous to the candidates. And I'm just wondering, what is wrong with a police officer being at an institution to secure the examination process?
They should be there.
Why are you saying
They should be inconspicuous?
Why?
The thing is that we had changed the police force into a police service, but really the reforms are not complete. How Kenyans still view police officers, even you and I, you know, Sam, is with hostility, some hostile person. When you have a police officer in full regalia with a gun, you know, walking around the compound, and more so in the center or in the examination hall themselves, it intimidates candidates unnecessarily. So I'm saying, if we are going to have police officers within the compound, and we may need some, let them be in civilian, like the officers who secure us. And this is just to ensure that the examination environment is not intimidating. It is good for candidates. We have candidates in primary for KCP who are as young as 12 years. And you know the perception, the subtle perception about the police. When you have a police officer who is not an invigilator, is not a supervisor, is a person securing the process from interferences beyond the examination room, in full regalia with a gun, the way you've been seeing them in photos, Sam, it surely intimidates. And I'm not saying this to say police officers should not be there, but I'm saying for those ones within the center, let them be inconspicuous. In places like northeastern Kenya, where you can have external interferences, aggressions during examination, they can be in uniform but outside the compound. Get what I mean? Very far from the sight of candidates.
Mheshimiwa Kaluma, when you look at this, in 2015, when Professor Kamenyu was the Cabinet Secretary for Education and there was that widespread cheating, I remember that time the only visible person in the education sector was just him, and the gentleman who was the Chief Executive Officer of NEC, Kivilu, if that name is correct.
Yes.
So after that, there was change of guard at the ministry, there was change of officers at NEC, and the government became more involved. So when you look from the transition from that period of 2015 to now, are there any good things you can report about?
I'm not saying that the government should not involve. In fact, there is no more important thing than examination, because it determines what you become in future. It's such a serious national event. What I'm saying is that the government should involve without the hype and noise we have. The government should involve by ensuring there are strong systems and institutions to secure integrity of exams. And I'm saying, if we funded Kenya National Examination Council well, mm-hmm. if we funded invigilators, supervisors mm-hmm. and others, mm-hmm. you would not have cabinet secretaries running around, because in any event, within the structure of exam mm-hmm. management,
right.
there is no role they have to play.
Mm-hmm.
If we established, you know, NEC well and firmed it up, there would be no problem. And really, Sam, contrary to what people think,
mm-hmm.
this is what happened.
Mm-hmm.
The examination integrity issues were not addressed because, you know, Matiang'i was minister.
Mm-hmm.
But because the rot in examination setting
mm-hmm.
and management at NEC
right.
was addressed.
Mm-hmm.
So if you strengthen institutions,
mm-hmm.
you strengthen management, and you resource well the system, we would be better. And that is why I'm saying this money is being wasted by cabinet secretaries and other top government officials,
mm-hmm.
you know, moving around with choppers.
Mm-hmm.
Our monies, which ought to have gone to invigilators and supervisors so that they are well fed, they are well taken care of,
mm-hmm.
and then at the level of parliament, we put punitive consequences against an invigilator who does not do his work well.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, in law, if, for instance, now you are a principal or a head teacher of a school,
mm-hmm.
you are a manager,
right.
if there is cheating in your school,
mm-hmm.
beyond just removing you from service,
mm-hmm.
we can terminate you, we can remove you completely.
Mm-hmm.
You get what I'm talking about?
Mm-hmm.
So with those measures and proper facilities,
mm-hmm.
we can go far. What I'm against is our misdirecting resources
mm-hmm.
to people who serve no worthful purpose in the examination management process.
Right. So do you think the CS will respond to your letter? You wrote it on 29th. Do you think it's coming?
Let me tell you,
mm-hmm.
Some of these things, we never write them so that they respond.
Yeah.
I'm at a policy-making level. And I can tell the CS that whether or not she responds,
mm-hmm.
I'm concerned as somebody who has been in the education sector. Some I was lecturing before I joined parliament,
mm-hmm.
and I've managed exams.
Mm-hmm.
These things are things I'm going to follow,
mm-hmm.
whether the CS responds to me or not. And
okay.
I think this is a matter we have to address in parliament.
Okay.
We don't want to give, you know, the international community the idea that dishonesty in Kenya is so inborn, it starts from, you know, examination. When you do that, the integrity of the certificates from our national examination,
that's how it has been.
You know, get law. No. Some bring any journalist, you will beat him. Bring any lawyer from any corner of the world on any area of law, I will beat him, and I've beaten them before. And I studied through the Kenyan system purely.
Mm-hmm.
So let us avoid situations which take the credit
mm-hmm.
of our certificates, the credibility of
mm-hmm.
our examination processes. One, by making too much noise there, by involving people who have no worthful role to play, by diverting resources other than giving it to the central management team,
all
which
right.
is NEC, and then we do the proper thing.
All right, Peter Kaluma Opondo, Member of Parliament for Homa Bay Town constituency, thank you so much for coming through to discuss this important matter about the examinations of the country. Of course, KCSE kicks off on the 5th of November, so I don't know whether we'll see more government officials, including the president, going to see the situation?
Let the president address the nation even today
mm.
and wish all KCSE candidates
uh-huh.
good luck. It is better than going into a single school. In fact, as a president, even those schools you cannot have time to go for as a single person
uh-huh.
want to hear you.
Okay.
Wish them well and trust your institutions, resource them well to secure that our examination management process has integrity.
Thank you so much for coming.